Hi, my name is Ronald Johnson, and what I do is I help people tie up who they are and where they are online. If you're in a situation where you lack success and is affecting all facets of your life and you wish you make that better, this is where I can help. I have years of experience, and this is where you could benefit from that transformation of awareness and your mindsets. So today it's going to be talking about, are you a victim of imposter syndrome? Or more importantly, do you even know what imposter syndrome is? Well, imposter syndrome really means that we're not our authentic self. Our easy way to explain it is that we're one way behind closed doors, but in another way around our friends because we want to be accepted and be liked. And the thing is, we don't know understand what they're saying or what they think about us, right? Because you can't read anybody else's mind, but we can't read a reaction to it. So I'm going to give you an example of what imposter syndrome is, how I suffer from it, and how I really got around it. So for so many years, my self-worth was tied up to I wanted people to look at me as a powerful man, as a man with a lot of money, smart, intelligent, good credit. Okay, the whole thing. The reality is I spent a lot of money on things I shouldn't have purchased. I wasn't the person that had good credit. I did file bankruptcy at one point in my life because I just had to get out of debt, and that's my early 20s. And that's what really defined me for decades, pretty much, from my late teens to my 20s to my early 30s, is that I want to be perceived a certain way. Because if I got perceived a certain way, I would be more accepted. But deep down inside was a small inner child which wasn't accepted, which was fearful of not being accepted. Because what imposter really means is that we're trying to have perception of the way people want you. Let me say it again. A perception of where we want people to view us. So while I want people to view me as a person had a lot of money, the person that was smart, that had good credit, I was none of those things. It's like every other person out there, yes, you're trying to pay your bills, you're trying to maintain certain things, you want to have luxury, but you know what? If I buy luxury, I won't be able to afford it. I didn't know how to manage my money. And that's what imposter syndrome really is you're not really showing up because you want to create this image of where you should be, which is not true. And what really happened is affect a lot of avenues of my life because that's the only way I gave my personal self-worth to, was that if I was perceived to be smart, intelligent, handsome, good looking, then I got more confidence. But the minute someone says, hey, what's your credit score? Oh, I have to lie. Or a minute someone says, hey, how can you drive a nice car? Oh, I have to lie. I'd say, well, I don't have the money right now, I'm trying to save. When in reality, I didn't have a good credit score, so if I had got a better car, I would be paying a crap ton in interest. But because I wanted to be viewed a certain way, because it gave me, I thought, what self-worth and self-confidence. And that was not really what I wanted to do. What I really wanted to do was be open and upfront, but that fear of not being perceived a certain way or not being able to fit in with a certain crowd hindered me from actually achieving my own gratification and my own success. Because the reality is that I had no idea what I was doing in life. And up until the last couple of years of really getting my awareness, really reading books and going through IPAC and becoming a life coach and all this stuff, I just was going through life. It's so like a lot of us out there right now, we're just going through life, just trying to navigate the best we can. And the minute someone, let's say something we don't like, immediately here comes aggression. So if someone said to me, Ron, oh, you don't have that much money. Oh, yes, I do. I know what I'm doing, because they attacked something I was weak at. And that's what happens to a lot of us. When people say something we don't like, we get aggressive, get upset because they're attacking what we don't like. But if we were up front with people, we wouldn't get hurt that way. So I'm going to tell you how would you do it to go around, or how to really understand imposter syndrome and not be a victim of it and be your authentic self. First step is we have no idea what people think about us. We can't read minds. What people say and what people do, or what people say and what people think, are always, completely different. I mean, 70% of people out there suffer from some imposter syndrome. So what we got to do really is understand that the only way to, let's say, not have people think about us in a different way is show up as we are. Not trying to create these images that don't exist, not create these images that are really not us, but show up where we are. If they don't accept the fact we're not a certain way, we don't fit a certain crowd, great. Maybe that wasn't meant for us. Or more importantly, if you don't fit in, get the learning out of it. Ask questions. Hey, you know what? How come I don't fit in with this crowd? Or why you don't like me? Or what's going on? And you may get a truth out of that. And they don't, next person. There's what, over 6 billion people in the world. If someone doesn't like you, you can move to the next person. Because the point is always being yourself. Because the minute you start creating these bubbles of a fictitious you, you have to keep up that lie forever. You have to keep up the lie of, I look a certain way, I want to be seen a certain way. And eventually, it becomes self-suffering because you don't create real relationships. You create fake relationships because you're not showing up as you should be, as your authentic self. And that's how you don't have real good friendships, or you don't have a successful career, or you don't have that relationship you always wanted because you don't show 100%. And that's why I can help people. If you're tired of who you are and where you are in life, and you want to transform that facet, relationships, career, success, this is what I can help, because I've been there. I create that fake Ron Johnson. I create this fake me because I want to be perceived a certain way. And in the end of the day, it wasn't beneficial for me or anybody else around me. Relationships were terrible. Job was terrible. And until I realized I'm the problem solution to my own problems, I need to change myself first, that's when life got better. So again, this is Ronald Johnson. And what I do is I help people that are tired of who they are and where they are in life. So if you're tired of certain way in your relationships, you're tired of showing up a certain way or tied in your relationship, this is where I can help. I have been there. I can give you a lot of experience, or more or less, it's give you certain awareness that's really not happening. Because when you bring awareness to what you're thinking about, it creates a change. So if you want to find me, you can find me on the Ron Johnson Life Coach on LinkedIn, Facebook. Obviously, I'm shooting a Facebook Live video, but also on YouTube, because I do offer a lot of motivational videos out there. And I do something new, because my red light in the background. So fun fact about me, red's my favorite color. Thanks for listening.